niggas blue, the nigga love, it's on this show. Run, nigga, run. Powder don't catch you, run, nigga, run. You better get away. Nigga, run, the nigga blue, the nigga love, it's on this show. Run, nigga, run. Powder don't catch you, run, nigga, run. You better get away. Nigga, run by my gate. Wake up, nigga, you slept too late. Run, nigga, run. Powder don't catch you, run, nigga, run. Better get away. Look down yonder, what I see. Great big nigga behind that tree. Run, nigga, run. Powder don't catch you, run, nigga, run. You better get away. Nigga, run. The nigga flew. The nigga lost his Sunday shoe. Run, nigga, run. The powder don't catch you, run, nigga, run. You better get away. Nigga, run. Powder don't catch you, run, nigga, run. Better get away. Look down yonder, what I see. Great big nigga behind that tree. Run, nigga, run. Powder don't catch you, run, nigga, run. You better get away. Nigga, run, the nigga flew, the nigga lost his Sunday shoe. Run, nigga, run, the powder don't catch you. Run, nigga, run, you better get away.
Bustin' not to mention no. Authentic gold clothes. Go hard or go home. Boy.
Go hard.
Bustin' not to mention no.
'80s baby break beat.
Fam TV, we here live in front of ONYX, and we getting ready to rip what's left of the beard. We're gonna take the beard off. We're gonna take the beard off. Say COVID-19. Couldn't get a place because I'm black. So we're gonna try to get presentable. We're gonna see if this works. All right? We're gonna see if this works. We're gonna get presentable. We're here at ONYX Barbershop. Check it out. Fam TV exclusive. It's your boy Frost. And we also gonna be talking to my brother, KDB, Kilo Delta. You got a new joint, Kilo Delta Bravo. Go pick it up right now. Go check him out. We're gonna go pick his brain for the reals. We'll see what's going on, all right? Check it out.
Yeah, you know, we here with KDB.
The one and only. Thank you for having me, Dre.
Yes. You know, thank you for cutting me.
Hey, cut's not done yet.
It's been a tradition with myself for years to come to my brother KDB.
Always hold my man down.
To get cut up. Desires, you know what I'm saying? He used to give me them designs when I was a young boy, you know what I'm saying? But we grown now.
That doesn't mean that you can't tap into youth, my friend. You know, you can always tap into youth.
No, but right now it's a strategic thing right now because we're looking for an apartment downtown, you know what I'm saying? And we got good credit, but we black. Oh. So now we're going to have to come with a conservative look to get these crackers to get me a motherfucking spot downtown so I can get my millions. You smell me?
Well, that's the thing, right? Real estate. So, you know, downtown is an alluring place, and it is the place of commerce. So you need to be situated where the money is
Yes.
in order to be prosperous
Yes.
and fully encapsulate the potential of Yes. your potential.
Yes.
So what do we want to do today, Dre?
We want to take it low. We want to get that Caesar.
Okay, you waving it up?
And no, we don't want to wave it up. That's That's player, that's pimping. No. We trying to go for systems analyst.
So you got an office here. You want it as bland as possible. Chicken with no
season. I want the seasoning.
You want the seasoning on the chicken?
It's like, yo, but before they taste it, they think it's just regular old fried chicken.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But when they taste it, they're like, oh God, some black people made this. They just got to do the credit check, call the jobs, and fuck off. When they hear KDB, you know? When they hear KDB, they don't know who he really is, you know?
Yeah. Hey, you know, coming from the West End of Toronto,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean? Started off with the group Crooks of the Round Table.
Yes.
Before we were Crooks of the Round Table, we were Criminal Shine.
Mm-hmm.
And that was basically with me and my boy Hampton, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's what they called him back then. And we used to run around with the tunes. Yeah. We used to run around with Toronto's little juvenile unit, you know, causing mayhem in the city, and you know, a lot of our music encapsulated the street life, you know?
Yeah.
You know, and it's like there's... Them times, Toronto was a different place, man. I always tell people it was a dark place. You just never knew back then. It's like anything could happen anytime, any place. You just didn't know where it was coming from.
Yo, you remember when the Red Man and Meth Man came here and niggas robbed the fucking box and the show couldn't even go on?
Oh, man. Crazy. I remember when guys robbed Puff that, no. Biggie Smalls.
They robbed Biggie.
They robbed Rob Biggie at Dundas. No, where is it? Was Young. Remember the pool hall by Young and Thing by the Big Slice?
Oh yeah. Young and College.
Yeah.
Like South of College. Gerard.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. Biggie was the only time I think he came to Toronto.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And he was in the thing, and men's are surrounding him in his party.
Yep, in the party,
and he busts
on
his gun.
Stage, and man, when he's on stage, he has his gold chain swinging left to right, and the man just went up and just popped it. And guess what Biggie said? He's like, yo, he basically was like, yo, I love that. Toronto's just like my place where I come from, New York. Because I guess when he came here, he never anticipated that to be this much hood mentality,
now.
Right?
Yeah.
Crazy.
Mm-hmm.
All this corona
madness. I grew a beard. I was like, shit. At least I got at least some hair back in it, you know? And I don't know, man. It's a mental drain, you know? Dealing with people, dealing with it, you know?
Yeah.
And there's some people who are sheeple. And there's some people who are thinking for themselves, you know? So, I can see who the survivors are gonna be. You know what I'm saying?
It's like, I took it as time to recalibrate myself, you know? It's like, I tapped in more into, like, things that I used to do.
Yeah.
Theater, like, yes. Arts.
Yes.
And other things that, you know, I had mind to do, which I never did. Like, I started a lot more video editing so forth.
Oh, yeah,
arts, I got into more of computer designing type stuff. So,
okay.
Like, a lot of the things you see visually, it's all coming from my head.
Okay.
Instead of being an extension from somebody else, right? So, it allowed me to tap back into, like, those lost, you know what I mean, attributes that I used to have as a kid that I was pretty good at, which kind of were shunned because of the regular occurrences in life, you know?
Yeah, and they say, you know, like, you know, you had to come out of COVID with, like, you learn something new, you know?
Well, the thing is, we should be learning something every day, though, right?
Yes.
Knowledge is infinite, right, brother? So it's like, as much as you think you know nothing.
Oh, you know what I mean? Exactly. That's the most wisest thing. Knowing that you don't know nothing.
And that's the thing. People like to hold on to what they know and don't want to share it. You know what they know. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that doesn't help us progress as a society, right?
As a world, as a people.
Mm-hmm.
True. So true.
Hey, man. This life, when you get older, you realize, you know, it's about the things that, you know, make you happy, man.
Mm-hmm.
And the simplest things at times should make you happy.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Sure. It's like you coming through, you know what I mean? Popping up out of nowhere. Like, those type of things, bro, are moments that you cherish. You feel me?
Mm-hmm. It's like, yeah, man. What do you mean? I was like, yo, I gotta cut all this bush. Who am I gonna go to? I gotta go find children, man. Because every time I grow my hair long and I'm gonna cut it, chew me. Yo, KDB.
I gotta give you the template, right? It's like,
right?
If I'm gonna give it, you know, you gotta come to me and get the template. At least so, you know, it's like, okay, I can't check him again, you know what I mean? You got something else to go to next time and be like, yo, let's follow this thing right there, you know what I mean?
Yes.
It's just what it is, man. You know, I don't expect people to always be able to get me.
Yes.
I do expect to always give you 100%, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Now let's talk about the music.
Okay.
Like, so where is, because you know, I know KDB when he was Killer Death Black.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But now it's some Kilo Delta Bravo.
It is, but even with that, right? It's like I kind of stripped myself of the whole KDB identity.
Okay.
Trying to make it more of natural me, right?
Okay.
And I figured, you know, the KDB thing, a lot of people hear it and it's attached to like a lot of political, you know what I mean, connotations, right?
Yeah.
And thing. So it's like, there's always something deep. But the Truman Show, Truman, which is me, you know, if you know me, you know, at times I could be a motherfucking clown.
Yes.
You know what I mean? I could be.
He said the Truman Show just widens up your box.
It widens up the box. It allows me to be more me within the music.
Yes.
I could rap on the craft, I could come on some singing stuff.
Yes. Get some dance things going on.
Exactly. And I don't have to worry about people scrutinizing.
Hey, that's not conscious.
Exactly.
You're fighting for the people. I thought you were fighting for the people.
Yeah.
What have you done for the community?
And that's a joke, right? Some guys are like, yo, with this whole thing popping off with all the Black Lives Matter movement, a man was like, yo, what are you gonna do with all this stuff? I'm like, what am I gonna do? I'm like, have you been listening to my music for the last 15 years?
I've been telling you about this. I'm
like,
done.
You know what I mean? Like,
I gotta get, listen.
What are you gonna do?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
After listening to my music. Because now I got to get money to actually back what I've been talking about.
Exactly.
So you can't find nobody with no money.
You can't have an initiative
if you're working ahead
without the proper backing financially, right? So you can say, yeah, you have ideas, but if you don't have the financial support, the harder your ideas.